In this screencast, we're going to work through the enthalpy concentration diagram and just go over the parts of it and how to read off of this. And then, so this is a pretty common enthalpy concentration diagram that you would see in a chemicals handbook or online, that for water and ethanol. So you can see with any kind of binary system phase diagram, we have our concentration of the alcohol in weight fraction. It's important to notice that, such that 100% ethanol is on the right side and 0% ethanol or 100% water is on the left side. So when we are determining the enthalpy of a component, we can't measure the absolute enthalpy, so we always use reference states. So what are the reference states for this system in this plot? Well, our reference usually has an enthalpy of zero and everything's with respect to that. So if we look at our enthalpy of zero, we see that water is at 0 degrees and ethanol is at 0 degrees for our enthalpy of zero. So as you would expect, going up to the boiling point for any mixture composition, we would get fairly straight lines. The only difference in it being linear and kind of curved could be due to the heat of mixing of these two components together. And since it's a weighted average, and this is also based on a weight fraction and not a mole fraction, it's important to use the appropriate units when you are using this chart. So in this case, it's important to make sure it's in terms of a weight fraction. So we won't go over how this is constructed. Probably the two most important lines on this plot, since we are looking usually at vapor-liquid equilibrium, is our boiling line, or a bubble point line, which is down here, kind of thicker. You can see it says boiling line. And our dew line, which is up here. So this is our dew point line and our boiling line. So as long as we're between these two lines, we have two phases, a vapor and a liquid. The next thing to point out are the temperature lines. So down below you can see our freezing line, as well as different temperature isothermal lines for our compositions of ethanol and water mixtures. So for instance, if we have a 50 weight percent ethanol mixture at 40 degrees, we would be right here. So we would have one phase, that being a liquid. And we can then see what the enthalpy of that mixture is by reading it on the y-axis, where we see enthalpy in kilocals per kilogram. So for our 40 degree 50 weight percent mixture, it looks to have roughly an enthalpy of somewhere around 40 kilocals per kilogram. Okay, there's three main lines that we want to look at still on this plot. One are these isothermal lines. So here I've highlighted 86 degrees, and this is Celsius. And if we have a mixture that ends up on this line, then we know we have two phases, one that's a vapor and one that's a liquid. And where this equilibrium tie line intersects the dew line and the bubble point line, the boiling line, we could get our phase compositions for the vapor and the liquid. So let's do that really quick. Let's say we have a 30 weight percent solution of ethanol and water at 87 degrees Celsius. So this is within our phase envelope. We can draw this point. So I go up from 30 weight percent until I get to our 87 degree line, which is right here. And at this point, I will follow this line upwards to the dew point line and downwards to the bubble point line. Where this intersects gives me my composition of our vapor, so maybe somewhere around 0.64. So Y, again, this is weight fraction, Y of our ethanol is 0.64, and I'll put weight to indicate that it is a weight fraction. And X for our liquid phase, and we do the same thing here. We go down where it intersects on that boiling line, and maybe this is around 0.17. So now we know we have two phases, given our 30 weight percent solution at 87 degrees. When this separates into the two phases at equilibrium, one will have 0.64 weight fraction of ethanol in the vapor phase, and the liquid phase will have 0.17 weight fraction of ethanol. And so that's how we use the tie lines. This auxiliary line that comes down and curves. I want to go over that really quick because sometimes that will show up on a plot. If you have a ruler, sometimes it's easier to just go vertically up from our lower point. So if you're along this A7 line, to track it to one point. And when we go vertical up and over, we can read our y-axis this way without having to track along both lines and both points. It's just a matter of preference, but you can see how that is used. So this way we could read, say, the enthalpy of the liquid phase, which maybe I would wager is around 80 kilocals per kilogram, and the enthalpy of our vapor phase here is probably pretty close to 400, let's say 390 kcal per kilogram. So now we have the enthalpy just like that, reading off of the y-axis. And you could get the enthalpy of our mixture, which here I'll say is our feed. And we just go where we started over, and although that's a bad line, I'm going to say it's about 160 kilocals per kilogram. So of course, this all comes down to being able to read off a plot accurately. So the last line I want to point out on this plot is a line that might give us an idea of whether or not there's an azeotrope. An azeotropic composition is one where the liquid composition is the same as the vapor composition. And so you can imagine this means that these tie lines are going to be vertical. You can probably read right off of here and see that we have a vertical line that says azeotropic composition for our 0.96 weight fraction of ethanol at 77.65 degrees Celsius. So that would be our azeotropic composition, something you may see off of one of these charts. The last thing I'll point out, which is kind of cool and which plays into doing some distillation work later using these diagrams, is that let's say we go back to our 0.3 and 87 degrees. I'm going to re-highlight that line. And we take that vapor off of, say, this flash tank, and we lower its enthalpy. So we decrease the temperature. Say we decrease the temperature to 80 degrees. Well, now if we decrease to 80 and allow them to reach equilibrium, we follow along the 80 line. So just to point out, we started with a 30 weight fraction mixture of ethanol, and by having the temperature at 87, allowing it to phase separate, and then dropping the temperature of the vapor down to 80, we get a vapor composition of ethanol that's almost close to 0.8, which is a significant difference. So you can see how we could ride along these tie lines and doing some separation calculations pretty easily. So in another screencast, we'll work through an example of a flash tank using this diagram.